I've spoken to so many people who feel like they're stuck because of something that they have done. And I keep wanting to tell them, you know, God has forgiven you and God has moved on. You're the one that is stuck. You're the one that is beating yourself up. It's okay to allow yourself to be forgiven and to learn from your mistakes and to go forth. But they have a hard time going forward and believing that this God is just holding them accountable and punishing them and just angry with them, when that can't be further from the truth. I'm often reminded of the story that Brendan Manning tells in the book Ragamuffin Gospel about this woman in a remote village. And this woman is having visions of Jesus Christ. And the people are so excited about this woman and her visions that news became circling, like rumors about this woman having visions of Jesus Christ spread all throughout the countryside until it reached the ears of the archbishop. And the archbishop decided that he needed to investigate this woman and her visions of Jesus Christ. Because see, the thing about churches is they need to control certain narratives. So this archbishop probably wanted to make sure whatever vision that this woman was having about Jesus, that it aligned with the church's view of Jesus. But that's my commentary. So the archbishop went and visited the woman and said, are you the woman that I've been hearing about that is having visions of Jesus Christ? And the woman said, yes, bishop, I am. And the bishop said, well, we need to have definitive proof that you are indeed speaking to the Jesus Christ, that you're not some crazy old woman. And so the woman asked, well, how are we going to get this definitive proof? And so the bishop said, okay, well, next time you see Jesus, ask him to tell you what sins I confessed in my last confession. And the woman's like, what? You want me to ask Jesus what sins you confessed? And the bishop said, yes. The woman said, all right. And so before the bishop left, he said to the woman, do not tell people that you're having these so-called visions of Jesus Christ until we have definitive proof that you are indeed speaking to Jesus Christ. And so the bishop went home and all was quiet. And he's thinking to himself, okay, I saw that. That potential controversy has been squashed. Then there were these rumors that began to circulate about a woman in a remote village that is having visions of Jesus Christ. So Archbishop was a little bit peeved. So he goes and visits the woman once more. And when he saw the woman, he said to her, you know, you weren't supposed to share with people that you were seeing visions of Jesus Christ until you spoke to me first. But now that I'm here, are you seeing visions of Jesus Christ again? And the woman said, yes, sir, I am. And so the bishop asked the woman, did you remember to ask Jesus the question? And the woman said, yes, I remembered. I asked Jesus what sins you confessed in your last confession. And the bishop gets a little bit nervous and he goes, okay, well, what did Jesus say? And the woman reached and grabbed the bishop's hands, held it in her own, gazed into the bishop's eyes and said, these are the exact words of Jesus. I can't remember.